Hello and welcome to PMT TV UK. So today I'm here to show you how to mic up drums with a very affordable setup of mics. So we're using the PGA microphones by Shure, and they've also got a couple of the Beta ones as well. So we've got two Beta 27s up here and also a Beta 91A and a bass drum. Something I wanted to say before we get into the microphones is you need to be aware of what room you're using, how it's affecting your sound and how it's going to change, you know, your end product, if you like. The room that we're using to record this video is actually quite small, and it's quite lively as well. So what we've done is we've put four Auralex sound acoustic tiles on the walls to help absorb some of those frequencies so they're not bouncing around all over the place. I definitely recommend that you make sure the room you're recording in is at least acoustically treated, or that it's big enough, or you know, it's the right shape to really get a decent room sound. Because without a decent room, no matter what microphones you have, you're not going to get the best results. So room is absolutely vital and key. Okay, so the first microphone I want to talk about today is the Shure SM57. It is an industry standard microphone. It handles higher SPLs really, really well. It's got a really flat frequency response, meaning that it's really, really good for all instruments, and you'll find that it's used for a lot of things, not only snare drums, used for like toms as well and other instruments. So I definitely recommend checking that out. They're really, really cheap as well. You can buy them at PMT online, obviously, so I definitely check that one out, because literally you'll be perfect with that microphone. The microphone we have on the rack, Tom, is a PGA98D. Now this is a condenser microphone, and it's a really, really, really small profile, meaning that it's perfect for miking up your toms, and any sort of drum that's on your kit, because, you know, as drummers, we might have the tendency to almost hit it, it's in our way. So because it's such a small profile, it makes it really, really good for that. It's also got the quick release mount that comes with it, which is absolutely fantastic. So getting it on and off your drums will be really, really good. And again, it's not too expensive and sounds absolutely fantastic. Okay, so moving on to my floor tom now, we're using the PGA 56 microphone. It's a dynamic microphone, and it's really, really good for snare drums and toms. Sounds absolutely fantastic out the box, and you'll get a really, really clear sound. So for the money, definitely worth it. My outside mic on my kick drum, so the one that's sort of positioned slightly in the porthole of the bass drum, but not actually in the bass drum, that one is a PGA 52. It's great for handling low frequencies. So again, for bass drums, and even if you're feeling really, really extreme, you can use it for floor toms as well. Really, really fantastic mic. Again, because it's part of the PGA range, it means it's more affordable for you guys. So definitely check that one out as well. And my inside microphone, which I'm using inside the bass drum, is a Beta 91A. Now, this is an industry standard microphone. You'll see it when you go to venues. And when the sound guy will run up to your bass drum and ask if you've got a porthole, then shove it inside your bass drum because it sounds so good. It's fantastic for low frequencies to get a really, really big sort of bassy and beefy sound. Fantastic for that. Shure have also redesigned the capsule inside the Beta 91A, so it sounds a lot more like the sought-after SM91. Which a lot of the mic guys will be really, really happy about. You know, the sound's fantastic. Altogether, it's an extremely decent mic. And even though it comes at a bit more money than the PGA range, it's definitely worth checking out if you have that extra cash to sort of splash out and record your drums with. Last but not least are our two overhead microphones. So we're using the Beta 27s. They are side-addressed super cardio mics, the first of their kind. The great thing about these mics is they have a switchable low-frequency filter and a three-layer internal pop filter reduce the background noise, making it perfect for miking live instruments. And also, these microphones, as well as the 91A inside my kick drum, they require very little EQ, if any at all, which makes them absolutely fantastic if you do want to record some drums with them, either in the studio or even using them live. So yeah, definitely check those ones out as well. Okay, so when it comes to close miking your drums, what you want to try and do is make sure that the mics are pointing towards the center of the drum. And not so that they're pointing towards the edge, because when you point to the edge, what you're going to get is a lot of those sort of harmonic frequencies. We're trying to get a nice full-bodied sound from either your rack tom, your floor tom, or your snare drum. Pointing into the center will be essential. In terms of distance away, something that I do is I use like a three-finger sort of measurement. So I'd use three fingers, and then from there sort of position it so it's that height above the surface of the drum. Again, there's so many different ways to do it, so there's no one right way to do it. That's just the way that I do it, and so far it's worked really well. Okay, so moving on to our overhead microphones. Now, there's so many different methods you can use when miking your drums with overheads. The method we've used today is the XY method, and purely because it gives you the least amount of phasing issues. Phasing issues is essentially where the sound reaches one microphone before it reaches the next one, which makes it sound really weird and sort of disjointed. So the X bar method, because they're placed really close together, it means that you get like not happening so much. When you are doing the XY method, make sure that both microphones are pointing inwards towards the drums and at a 90 degree angle. So both of them have sort of made the 90 degree angle. That way you're gonna get the best sort of overhead sound. And again, try and make it so that your snare drum and your bass drum are sort of in the middle of this setup. That way in your stereo picture, they're gonna be center, which will sound really, really good when you're trying to record the whole kit. Okay, and then moving on to miking your bass drum. Now let's only talk about the external bass drum that we're using today, because some of you might not have the funds to use two bass drums or have enough inputs on your interface, etc. So let's just talk about the outside bass drum. So when you're doing that, I recommend cutting a porthole in your bass drum if it doesn't already have one already. What you want to do is you sort of want to position it inside that porthole, off-center a little bit to get the most body out of your bass drum sound. Something to remember is that all of this is just what we do and what people have done in the past. When it comes to miking drums and miking any instrument, although there's sort of like tips and pointers to get the best sound, it's all subjective. Like there's been so many different people trying out different things, so I'd definitely recommend that when you do get your microphones, just mess about. Mess about depending on what room you're using, you know, having your overheads a little bit higher, a little bit lower, whether you use the XY method or a different method like the recorder man record method, sorry, where essentially you have one of your overheads just above your floor tom and below your cymbals, and then another one directly pointing towards the center of your kit. It's all subjective. It's all about what sort of sound you're trying to achieve. So please don't take this as the absolute God's given fact. This is just a method that we use and a method that other people use as well. So yeah, I really hope you guys have enjoyed this video. If you haven't, then please hit that subscribe button. If you're on Facebook, then press the like button, all that stuff. Please leave a comment below letting us know what mics you're using and what methods you're using. We love to learn from you guys as we like to try and teach you. I'm Josh. I really hope you learned something from me today. And yeah, so hopefully we'll see you in the next video. Cheers.